Yes, Congresswoman Castro.
This is just a manifestation, Mr. Chair. And I know naman, this Quadcom would like to have this accountability, no? As regard to the EJK, etong Pogo, atrocities, at iba pa. While we are talking about extrajudicial killings about the dangerous drugs, imamanifest ko lang din, Mr. Chair, pero this is for your perusal, for your action, the Quadcom, to refer it to the rules. Dahil, Mr. Chair, related sa extrajudicial killings, yung mga patayang naganap sa panahon ni President Duterte tungkol doon sa mga aktivistang mga pinatay. At ang dami niyan at naka-refer yan sa Committee on Public Order and Safety. At alam namin, Mr. Chair, sa makabayan, related din ito sa human rights violations. Mr. Chair, since the 18th Congress, we have been submitting several House resolutions about the extrajudicial killings of activists, individual din na nadamay, no, doon sa mga operations ng PNP, ng AFP, Mr. Chair, sa panahon ni Duterte. So can you, Mr. Chair, can you take cognizance then so that this could be referred to the rules for proper action, Mr. Chair?
Thank you, Congresswoman Castro. Yes, of course, the committee will take cognizance of all the measures, privilege speeches, House resolutions that will be referred to this Quadcom. In the meantime, since most of these House resolutions have already been referred to a different committee, may we likewise ask the authors of the said speeches and resolutions to write to the chairperson of the committees to where your resolutions were referred initially so that we will not violate any provision of our rules before a change of referral will be done, because this would require a plenary action, Your Honors. So I hope we can do that as soon as possible so that the committee, the Quadcom, can immediately take cognizance of all these resolutions.
Chairman, if I may, no?
Okay.
Because that is...
Congressman Fernandez.
Yes, Congressman, it was mentioned by Congresswoman Franz Castro that it was referred to Committee on Public Order and Safety. And I believe it was already tackled on the first... First, nasa second reading na ba yan or ano? Have we discussed that in the Committee on Public Order?
Wala pa, Mr. Chair, yung mga EJK, and, human rights violations ng mga pagpatay sa mga mga activists. So ni-refer sana namin ito sa human rights, pero it was referred to your committee, Mr. Chair. Wala pa tayong nadi-discuss ever.
So the best thing to do is the recommendation of the chairman to change the referral of the subject resolutions. I think that is dalawang resolution na tayo yan, that was filed. Isang resolution at isang House bill, if I'm not mistaken. I'm trying to check with the COMSEC, and then the right action will be the one that was discussed by the chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I saw Congressman Irudy a while ago, but he's not here. But anyway, Mr. Chairman, there's also a privileged speech by Congressman Irudy with regards to Chinese national also in Isabela. And it was referred to the Committee on Justice. And well, in fact, nakapag-isang hearing na rin sila. So, Mr. Chairman, can we direct the COMSEC also to coordinate with the Congressman Inodi at the same time for change of referral to this committee, Mr. Chairman? Thank you.
Yes, Chairman Paduano, the committee secretariat is likewise directed to coordinate with the Committee on Rules and the authors to where these resolutions were referred initially, as well as the privileged speeches that were also referred to the different chairpersons. So, in order for us not to violate any rules that we have agreed and adopted in this 19th Congress, COMSEC, you are directed to coordinate with the Committee on Rules with respect to the change of referrals of all these speeches and resolutions.
Okay, Mr. Chair,
yes, may also Congressman say something. Manuel.
Yes, Mr. Chair, counting remarks lang as author of several of the measures referred to this joint committee, ang quad compo natin. Yours truly is an author of House Resolution number 14, ang pag-investigate po dun sa mga EJ case under the War on Drugs. House Resolution 1847 na nagsisik din ng pagbubuo ng joint committee. Tsaka meron din po tayong House Bill 10525 na bill po natin na gusto ding iban ang mga POGO. Tayo din po ay member ng tatlo out of the four committees sa Public Order and Safety, Human Rights, tsaka sa Dangerous Drugs. And at first, Mr. Chair, nung una nga talaga ang initial na perception ng mga kababayan natin ay hiwa-hiwala yung mga issue na ito. Usapin ang POGO, yung sa drug war killings. At ngayon, Mr. Chair, mabuti at nauungkat na natin talaga na ganito pala yung mga eskema na nangyari noong nakarang administrasyon. In fact, nandiyan pa yung mga pulis mismo na sila yung pumapatay doon sa mga kabataan natin. Tapos may mga indicators nga as mentioned sa mga press conferences na pinanggamit para bayaran yung mga pulis, para gawin yung mga patayan ay POGO money pa. Tapos may mga personalities ng past administration na involved naman pala sa illegal drug trade at andyan pa yung mga unlawful transactions to make all this possible. Ibig sabihin, Mr. Chair, kung meron tayong ilang mga gusto talaga nating maungkat dito, yung una, yung pagiging peke. No? Kailangan nating aminin, peke yung drug war ng past administration. Ginamit ito, yung pagpatay sa mga mahihira bilang cover-up na yung nangyayari palang drug war ay war laban dun sa mga kalaban sa ibang mga, nasa ibang linya ng drug trade. Ganun pala yung naging eskema. Kaya hindi natin talaga natumbok yung mga big names dun sa drug war. Sunod, Mr. Chair, common yung role ng police sa lahat ng mga ito. Kaya naman, in these grand, horrible schemes, kailangan yung mga top police officials ng past administration dapat ay dumalo. Kaya Mr. Chair, standing, I believe, yung invitation natin kay former PNP Chief and Senator Bato de la Rosa to answer questions. Mr. Chair, in terms of interparliamentary courtesy na gusto niyang i-invoke para hindi siya dumalo dito, we would like to inform him na merong president na ang isang member ng House of Representatives nga ay pumunta mismo sa Senado nung maimbitahan, former Kabataan Party List Representative Sara Ilago, dumating sa isang investigation. Which means, kung ang isang member ng House ay nakakapunta sa Senado to attend investigations, what exempts a senator na pumunta dito sa atin para din sumagot sa ating mga tanong? Pero ang ginagawa niya, Mr. Chair, kung ano-ano mga diversions, he even uses the platform of the Senate at pati yung resources ng taong bayan, Mr. Chair, for his diversions, habang hindi siya dumadalo dito. Kaya, if he truly cares about Filipino families, if he truly cares about the welfare of young people, dapat umattend siya, Mr. Speaker, Mr. Chair. So, clarify lang po natin na dahil ang invitation sa kanya ay galing sa Committee on Human Rights, I would like to clarify kung standing pa rin po ba na nung binuo na natin itong QuadCom, ang invitation sa kanya ay nandyan pa rin. Yun lang, Mr. Chair, for clarification.
Okay, thank you for that lengthy manifestation, Congressman Manuel. Answering your question tungkol dun sa standing invitation, yes, the committee recognizes that one of the member of the QuadCom has invited former Chief PNP and now Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa in the one of the committee hearings of the Committee on Human Rights. And since all the activities and rulings of the chair of the Committee on Human Rights has now been forwarded to the QuadCom, we will take cognizance of the actions taken by the committee chair. And to answer your query, yes, the invitation still stands. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay, Congressman Fernandez.
I think there are certain issues that we need to be clarified because we have different separate committees. And different separate committees have already manifested their intention to elevate some certain issues of the different committees. I, for one, have elevated the issues of POGOS concerning a lot of things. And I, if I may, Mr. Chair, to elevate also the issue of the order of contempt and the detention of one of the resource speaker to be elevated on this quadcom. But unfortunately, it was, not unfortunately, but it was moved by one of the members of the committee to continue the discussion of the POGO in relation to some, what do you call that, parochial issues, which is not in relation to the quadcom, that to the issue that will be discussed in the quadcom. So certainly, Mr. Chairman, there are issues that we need to elevate, but there are those that need to stay on the separate committees. I think the good chairman of the public accounts have the same kind of issue in relation to some pertinent issues that should remain on the Committee on Public Accounts. Same thing with the Committee on Public Order. So, with that, Mr. Chairman, I'm elevating the issue of the contempt order on the person of certain Ronaldine Baterna in the Quadcom Committee.
Thank you, Congressman Dan Fernandez. Your manifestation is likewise noted. And now the Quadcom takes cognizance of the action of the Chair of the Committee on Public Order and Safety, most specifically the contempt orders and the detention of a certain resource person in his committee.
So, Mr. Chair, another short question.
Okay. Is this a question?
Yeah. Kasi ano lang to eh, continuing sa mga invitation namin sa AJK, sa HR. Okay. Dahil, Mr. Chair, kahit naman na sa POGO eh, kahit sa POGO, isa lang yung responsible dito na nagbigay ng policy. Kahit sa EJK ng mga sa ating mga EJK sa ano no, sa dangerous drugs ay isa lang din yung tinutukoy na responsible. So, are we going to extend also our invitation to President Duterte since he is not already the president and he can he should answer the queries that we are going to make from him, di ba? Kasi si Senator Bato, so meron tayong ano no, meron tayong invitation, and kung mayroong parliamentary courtesy, what would be the attitude of this Quadcom regarding President Duterte, Mr. Chair?
Okay, thank you, Congresswoman Castro. The invitation sent by the Chair of the Committee on Human Rights in the last committee hearing they had, still stands. As I mentioned earlier, whatever actions and rulings made by the chair in relation to the issue that the Quadcom will be tackling still stands. And meaning the invitation is still extended to the former president.
Mr. Chair, follow up. What if hindi siya pumunta? Anong gagawin natin? Kung hindi siya pupunta, ano po yung gagawin natin? Well, are we going to have, like yung, syempre, yung rules natin, like yung, ibigyan natin ng Shoko's order, contempt, are we going to use that procedure, Mr. Chair?
Mr. Chair, can I interject, Mr. Chair?
Okay.
Before we answer siguro all the questions, I think we have to approve the ground rules first of the Quad Committee bago po natin may sagot yung mga imbitahin, what are we going to do?
Okay. If the Congresswoman Castro would allow the chair to go on first with the agenda for today's hearing, as requested by our Vice Chair, Congressman Fuentebella. But let me just answer the question raised by Congresswoman Castro. You know, the House of Representatives respects and gives due courtesy to a co-member, a co-legislative body member, meaning whether he's a senator or a congressman, the tradition of inter-parliamentary courtesy exists. And the committee wishes to recognize that. Sa invitation sa ating former president, it is up to the former president if he refuses to attend. Again, anybody for that matter that we wish to invite will likewise be extended courtesy. Of course, as to the next action after the courtesy is extended, then the committee must rule and approve whatever actions we wish to take. In other words, for the Senator Bato and the former president, courtesy, and in deference to the former president, he should be given likewise courtesy. As to the next action, then we will have to decide on it when we come to that point. Now, since there are no more...
If I may, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, please. And Congressman Fernandez.
And as a matter of courtesy to those personalities, we have to consider a lot of things as well. There are a lot of options that can be considered. And as a matter of fact, before going to the proper procedure of trying to have issue a show cause order or a subpoena, we deem it right that with the approval of the body that we need to have a lot of options. And along the way, we will find one without hurting relationship, no? But of course, at the end of the day, it is the member who will move for the invitation to those personalities. So let's exhaust muna yung possibilities that mag-explain din sila. For example, if they write a letter explaining the reasons, then the body can consider a lot of things. So most likely, we will cross it when we reach it.
Thank you, Congressman Fernandez.